Welcome back to another video. Today we are going to look at numbered headings and subheadings. Numbered lists have been covered many, many times in articles and videos. Some good, some not so good. This will be a short and sharp guide to get you up and running. Numbered headings are created using multi-level lists. We can define a new multi-level list from the multi-level list drop-down menu. A new pop-up will open. On the left, we can select different levels to modify. In the center, we can see a preview of the list being created, showing the numbering and spacing. Below that, we can change the formatting and list style for the current level. Below again, we can change the position of the text. And pressing the button in the bottom left will open more options. These new options allow us to link the current level to a heading style, the key to our problem. We will work through the example of having three levels of numbers, with a full stop between each value, in the format of 1.1.1. We will start at level 1. First, link level 1 with heading 1. Whenever we apply heading style 1, the numbering will be applied. We will keep it as a numbered style, but we want to remove the end bracket. The number will be left aligned at 0 centimeters with the text indented to 1.5 centimeters. You can actually press the Set for All Levels button to apply text indentation to all levels at once. Very useful, but requires a bit of experimentation to get the desired outcome. We can move on to level 2. Link level 2 to heading 2. We will change it to a numbered style and then change the formatting. Formatting for level 2 onwards takes a bit more work. The current number shown is for level 2. Place a full stop in front. In front of that, we will include the number for level 1. And this gives us the 1.1 number formatting. Again, we will left align to 0 centimeters with a 1.5 centimeter text indentation. And finally, on to level 3. Link level 3 to heading 3, change to a numbered style, and then take some time applying the number formatting. Add a full stop in front of the level 3 number. Then include level 2, add another full stop in front, and then include level 1. This gives us the number format of 1.1.1. Left align level 3 to 0 centimeters with a text alignment of 1.5 centimeters. 1.5 centimeters might need to be increased, especially if you end up using a lot of headings in your document. For example, a report with lots of levels and lots of headings will run into spacing issues. From here, you can continue doing lower levels, but for my project, three levels of numbering will be more than enough. The numbered list can now be applied by using styles in the top ribbon. Click on a heading or line of text and press the required heading style. If you want to expand the number of levels, or you find a mistake with the formatting, simply press on the Define New Multilevel List to open up the portal to make changes. Multilevel lists can be difficult at the best of times, so I suggest having a plan before starting. Know exactly what you're aiming at. If you have any tips or tricks when using multi-level lists, leave them below in the comments. We would love to hear them. Thanks for watching. See you next time.